Good morning, children. Hope you are fine. In the last class, I have taught you about the correspondence, transversal, exterior, alternate interior angles, and alternate exterior angles. So once again, we will revise it again. See two parallel lines where the another line intersect each other. The two lines are three lines. It is not like only two lines has to come. Parallel line should be there. The two parallel lines. Okay? Where it doesn't meet. The line crosses that intersect this parallel line is a transversal line. Okay? So their forms are angles. Their forms are angles. So, first we have learned about the correspondence angle. What is correspondence angle? The angles which has a different vertices. Different vertices. See, this is correspondence angle. Angle 1. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay. So, angle 1 and angle 5 will be the correspond. In the same way, 2 and 6, 3 and 7, 4 and 8 are the correspondence angle. Okay. So, next we came to the alternate angles. Alternate angles means which is having the opposite interior angles or opposite exterior angle. Angle 3 and angle 4. Angle 6, sorry. Angle 3 and angle. This is alternate interior angle. Alternate interior angles. Again, alternate exterior angle. Exterior angle. This is exterior angle. Alternate exterior. Okay. Angle 2 and angle 7. In the same way, angle 1 and angle 8. Okay. Alternate. Here, angle 4 and angle 5 will be the alternate interior angles. Okay. Did you understand this? Next, pairs of interior angles on the same side. Pairs of interior angles on the same side. However, this is alternate interior. Pair means two angles. See, 3 and 4 will be the alternate angle of 5 and 6. This both. Interior angle. This is the interior, pair of interior angles. And as usual, pair of exterior angles will be the 1 and 2 and 7 and 8. Okay? So, now we will come to the exercise 5.2. Exercise 5.2. Okay. So, few sums are there. We will complete it. Okay. Coming to the first. State the property that is used in each of the following statements. I'll draw the diagram first. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry. Yeah, 4, 3 and 4 here. 5, 6, 7, 8. We have to state the property that is used in each of the following. If A is parallel to B, this is parallel. This symbol shows you that parallel, then angle 1 is equal to angle 5. If A is, this is A, this is A, this is B. If A is parallel to B, then angle 1 will be equal to angle 5. How it is? In which property you are coming across? The two parallel lines A and B are cut in by the transversal. Then 1 is equal to, because they are corresponding angle. Isn't it? See, 1 and 5. 1 and 5. I show this is corresponding angle as they are corresponding angle. Okay. So this is transversal line. A and B is cut by the transversal line. So the angle 1 and angle 5, which is formed, is a corresponding angle. So they will be equal to each other. In second, first question. If 4 is equal to 5, if angle 4 is equal to angle 6, then A is parallel to B. So if angle 4, angle 4 and angle 6 are equal, which is as 4 and 6. What is this? Alternate interior angles. 4 and 6 is alternative interior angles. So equal measurement means they are interior angles, as they are interior angles. Can write only anterior angles. 4 and 6, they are parallel to each other. The A and B is parallel. So when A and B is parallel, the transversal line, it forms an angle. A, 4 and 6, they are alternate interior angle. So they are, A is parallel to B. If, third, if angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree. See here. Angle 4 and 5. Okay. See here. Don't observe anything. Angle 4 and 5. This is 180 degree. Okay. This is 180 degree. The A is parallel to B. Will that? Then A is parallel to B. Yes. They are transversal line. This is a transversal line. So when two parallel lines is intersect with another angle, distinct angle line, so they are called transversal line. So A is parallel to B. Then two parallel lines are cut by transversal. Angle 4 and angle 5 are pairs of interior angle 4 and angle 5 is interior angle. This is interior. If 4 and 6 means alternate interior angles. This is alternate interior. This is only interior angles are in the same side or on the same side of the transversal. It is supplementary angle. It is supplementary. 180 degree means it is supplementary angle only. Okay. 180 degree it is coming means it is supplementary angle. Got it? Did you understand? See, if A and B is parallel, then what is 1 and 2? They are corresponding. 1 and 5 is corresponding angle. So, if 4 is equal to 6, then A is parallel to B? Yes. It is a transversal line and they are alternate interior angles. What is 4 and 6? They are alternate interior angles. So, this is parallel line. As transversal line has come here, so it forms a 4 and 6 is a alternate interior angle. So A is parallel to B. If 4 and 5 is 180 degree, then is it alternate? This is A and B is parallel. Yes, it is inside the line, isn't it? It is forming interior angle. So this is supplementary. I have drawn in green color. This is supplementary angle. So it is a parallel line. Understood? So next. Second, if in the adjoining figure identify this is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Then what they ask? The pair of corresponding. We have to show the pair of corresponding angles. Pair of, now say, pair of corresponding angle. So, which are the corresponding angle? Angle, there are four pairs. There are four pairs. Four pairs of corresponding angle. That is, first one is 1 and 5. This 1 and 5. Second is two and six. Next, four and eight. Next is third is here. And three and seven are corresponding angle. Okay. The pairs of alternate interior angle. The pairs of alternate interior angle. There are two, no? That is angle interior angle ma 1, 3 and 5. Angle 3 and 5, angle 2 and 8. Alternate interior angles. 3 and 5 and 2 and 8. Next is third. Only interior, pairs of interior angle on the same pairs of, you have questions in the textbook children, I am writing in the short, pairs of interior angle, which is having on the same side, same interior angle. Okay, there are two, that is 3 and 8 and 2 and 5. Interior. It is not alternate. See here. Angle 3 and 5 means interior, alternate interior. Here, only interior angles. 3 and 8. 2 and 5. That's all. Fourth one. That is in this only sub question. Fourth. The vertically opposite angle, vertically opposite angle, vertically opposite means we have to write one and one set. First set is 1 and 3, angle 1 and 1 angle 3. Second set is angle 2 and angle 4 and angle 2. Okay, this is third set, 8 and 6. Angle 8 and angle 6. Next is angle 5 and angle 7. They are vertically opposite. 5 and 7, 8 and 6. 1 and 3. 4 and 2. Okay? Vertically opposite. Okay, children, did you understand? When you understand the vertically opposite, what is interior one, what is exterior angle? It is very easy, children. So, third, in the adjoining figure, P is parallel to Q. Find the unknown angles. This is parallel line. Okay. When it is adjoining, this is angle P and angle, line P and If it adjoins the transversal line, it forms angles. It is 125 degree. We have to find out F and E. This is 125. What is angle A, B, C and D? Look here, A, B, C, D. Here, E, F. So now we have to find out angle E. As it is 180 degree, the straight angle. Angle P, the line P is equal to 180 degree. It is straight angle. Okay, this is straight angle. In that, you have to subtract 125. So you get 65 degree. This is 65 degree, isn't it? 5, 7. 7 minus 2 is 55. Okay, 55 degree. This is 55. And F is also 55 as it is vertically opposite. Angle E is equal to 55 degree. Okay, angle F is E is equal to angle E because vertically opposite. It is vertically opposite. So therefore F is equal to 55 degree. F is 55 degree. Now we have to find out A, B and C, D. Okay? A, B, C, D. Now, third one. First is E. E value we found out. Second is F value we found out. Third, angle A is equal to angle E. That is 55 degree. Why? Because it is alternate interior angle, corresponding angle, sorry. It is corresponding angle. So B is also an angle. B is equal to 125. Corresponding angle. Okay. E and E, this is 55 degree and this is 125 degree. And now as it is vertically opposite, D will be 125 and C is 55 degree. Angle D is vertically opposite to of angle B, that is equal to 125 degree. Fourth, then fifth, angle C is equal to 55. Because it is vertically opposite to B. Sorry, A. Vertically opposite to A. ये एंगल ये, as it is corresponding angle it is A and E is 55 degree and that 125 is 125, that is B is also a corresponding angle. So in this way one sum has been completed. We have to find out the x value like this. Next, in the figure given, last I'll do the other one, fourth one, I am sending in through the PDF. You can do it there only, children. That is as it is. Okay. So you can understand, I'll send it in the PDF. Okay. Now we'll find the last sum of this lesson. That is, in the given figure, fourth in your this one, this is fifth sum in your textbook. It is fifth sum, the given figure. Two angles are adjoining. Okay, two angles adjoins each other. A, B, this is 70 degree. C, D, E, F. Okay? The arms of two angles are parallel if angle ABC is equal to 70 degree, then find the two arms, isn't it? They are parallel, A and D, here BC and EF, they are parallel. Okay, so we have to find out one A angle DGC. Angle D, here G will come. Okay, here the angle D, G, C. What is this angle D, G, C? So, angle D, G, C is equal to angle A, B, C. This both will be equal because it comes here only, no? Okay, D, G, C. This is 70 means this is also will be 70 degree. Okay. And angle, second one. Angle DEF. Angle DEF. When angle ABC is 70, angle the same parallel. It is parallel, no? So it is equal to 70 degree.
70 degree.
So when one angle is the same, the other angles also will be the same angles. Okay, corresponding angle or interior angle, all will be equal to each other. So here completes your geometry one lesson, children. So write this. I'll send, I have sent already the PDF, children. Please check that and start writing the classwork. Check the, if you have written the classwork, check it once again and send, submit for the correction. Okay, so have a nice day, children.